The pH concept. Most of you have heard of pH. pH is a nice way of telling whether you have an acidic, basic, or neutral solution. There's a formula for pH. pH is equal to the negative log of H3O plus concentration. Log stands for logarithm. Some of you are familiar with logarithms and have calculators that can handle those. Another thing we might mention right here too, this H implies hydrogen ion, and so a lot of times we'll indicate H plus concentration. We sort of use those two interchangeably. A little simpler formula, if we rearrange this, is that if you have a concentration of H3O plus expressed in this format, this number up here, the exponent, is the pH. For example, if you have an H3O plus concentration of 1 times 10 to the minus 5 molar, the pH is simply that number, pH is 5. Or H3O plus of 1 times 10 to the minus 11, pH would be 11. For a neutral solution, when our concentrations are 10 to the minus 7th molar, a neutral pH would be 7. As we look at the top of this board then, a pH of 7 is a neutral condition or solution. If we have a pH that's below 7, it's acidic. Above 7 is basic. And that's a lot easier scale than looking at negative exponents and trying to decide which is larger and which is smaller. This pH scale is very handy. It leads us now to a couple of skills. If you were given a pH of 4, for example, we could ask, what's the H3O plus concentration? What's the OH minus concentration? Is it an acidic, basic, or neutral solution? Or given any one of these three, solve for the other two. So there are a couple of skills there. Let's work a problem associated with that. We said that we had a solution where the pH is equal to 4. Well, then that means that the H3O plus concentration is 1 times 10 to the minus 4. Using the ion product of water, we could solve for OH. The OH concentration must be 10 to the minus 10, so that the product of these two is 10 to the minus 14. And then finally, let's decide if it's an acidic, basic, or neutral solution. Well, comparing these two solutions can sometimes be confusing, so let's just keep in mind the pH. We said the pH was 4, it's below 7, must be an acidic solution. Here's a little bit harder problem. Given a pH of 11.3, let's see what we can find out. Well, I know first of all that the solution's basic, because it's a pH greater than 7. And I'd have to use a calculator with logs to solve for H3O plus, and then we could solve for OH minus. And you might have a question like this. If you did, there'd only be one. You wouldn't have 3 or 4 questions on an exam on the same concept. So never let one concept destroy your confidence. If you aren't confident in handling logarithms, don't know how to use your calculator, we've got a little section in the text that describes this. But again, every calculator is different, and so it may not fit your calculator. Here's still another way around the dilemma, and it's a strategy for multiple choice questions. Let's see if we can narrow down the responses. If you've got 4 responses, let's pick out the one that's most likely the correct answer. I know that if the pH is 11 something, that we're in the neighborhood of H3O plus concentration being 11 or 12. And so here's the answer that I'd look for. It's something times 10 to the minus 12. Because if I were to convert this number, this is the H3O plus concentration, if I were to convert this into a pH, sort of the reverse of what we're doing, I'd look to this exponent, it's 12. Over here, if we took the negative logarithm of that, it's going to reduce that 12 a little bit. In other words, it's going to be 11 something. So we'd look for something or other times 10 to the minus 12. Taking an educated guess is a good strategy for some multiple choice questions. Let's look at another problem like that. Here's another problem where having a calculator that handles logarithms would be an advantage, but not a necessity. If I'm given H3O plus concentration of 2.7 times 10 to the minus 9, well, we could use the ion product of water equation and solve for OH minus. We know that the product of these two is 10 to the minus 14th, and so we're able to do that. We could also compare these two and look to see the negative exponent that's the smallest. That means that the OH minus concentration is greater. The solution must be basic. But now to solve for pH, well, we're going to have to be able to take the logarithm of that 2.7. And again, if you're not comfortable in using a calculator to do that, let's make an educated guess. 10 to the minus 9, I know that the pH is going to be close to 9. And this, the 2.7 part, is going to have a negative logarithm, which is going to reduce that 9 a little bit. In other words, our answer is 8 point something. So I'd look at the four responses that are there and look for the 8 point something, and that's our answer. And that sort of leads me into an overall strategy for multiple choice questions. I'm sure that you've developed your own philosophy and method by now, but maybe there'll be something new here. Ideally, when you work a problem, a multiple choice problem, you look for the answer that matches yours. In other words, you work the problem first before you look at the answers. With more time, you can go back through an exam and you can verify that the other three distractors are wrong, that they don't fit the correct profile. And finally, number three is a technique that we've just used here. We narrow down the possibilities and take an educated guess.